students. So, you know what? I didn't know the classroom. So I went to the our building, 118, and nobody was there. So I thought, oh, I'm very lucky. Is this lucky or not? Anyway, yeah, this is the funniest guy in the department. I mean, yeah, let me introduce yourself.
Myself?
Oh, this, no, honestly, this is my first teaching in the library. So everything seems like very, very unusual. So, I believe I have about 20 minutes for the introduce myself, and my understanding is I will talk. Let's talk about the computer science program, especially software engineering concentration. And I know, I think so many of you guys, no, only a few. At the top, we have new students a lot, right?
Maybe a lot of these, yep.
Yeah, transfer students. Now, this is my background. Okay, this is my background. I received my PhD degree in computer science in the University of Florida. Can you, have you been there, Florida? Yeah. Can you guess? Wow, that's a really nice place, right? Florida, like Disney World. And that was a really cool place. Not cool, it's a very hot place. And let me introduce myself a little bit. Originally, I came from South Korea, and I received my bachelor degree in computer engineering. And then I received my computer science master degree in, I think this is one of the best in the world, actually. Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology. This is a really good university. After that, I worked for a research company like AT&T Bell Lab is really good research company, right? I mean, this is world best. Not like that, but a similar one in Korea, Korea Telecommunication Research Center. So I worked there for 5.5 years. Okay, so over there I developed several software tools. After that, okay, I decide, okay, I want to study, and I hope I wanted to be a professor, actually. So because of that, I came here, University of Florida, and I studied hard, of course, and then I got my PhD degree. Then, you know what, my first job actually is not here, CSUMB. Actually, my first job was in Pennsylvania. So have you been there, Pennsylvania? Actually, Pennsylvania is pretty big, right? It's not big like California, but it's big. But my university was very, it's a Canadian board, actually. It's a very cold area. Have you heard about the snow belt? Have you heard about that, snow belt? You know the lake, right? The lake area. So the thing is, there are very big, many lakes, very big lakes, and during the winter, cold wind comes from what? Canada. So typically, water is what? Cold or hot, compared to the land. It is not cold, I mean, not hot, of course. So because of that, cold wind become snow. So this is what? A lot of tons of snow on my area. So when I work in, when I study in Florida, I didn't see any snow at all, never ever, right? But when I go there, I saw first snow on November. So okay, so everybody like first snow, wow, snow. But what happened is November, okay, snow. That's very good. December, of course, it's winter, right? January, a lot of snow. What do you think about February?
Snow.
Still snow. Okay. How about the March?
Snow.
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 April. No, it's snow. I'm not joking. April, school was closed because of snow. It's not usual, of course, but snow. And I saw last snow May 2nd. 2 weeks later, it was a summer break. Wow. Okay. I decided to move because if you like to ski a lot, that's a really good place. But now.
That's double your driveways.
Wow. Yeah. Now, so that's my background. So I came here about 6 years ago, and I joined the computer science program. And my teaching experience is pretty much software development. So if you are the CD major, hey, how many CD major students? Okay, how about computer science? Oh, majority, I think, computer science, right? Yes, I think. Okay.
About 60% computer science.
Yeah. Even your background is CDE. I'm a software developer, software side professor. So pretty much I taught all types of language, C++, data structure, software design, algorithm, computer architecture, and software engineering. So that is my teaching experience. So now, I have involved many projects, real projects, I mean industrial projects. So let me introduce three things. First one, this is ongoing project, California wireless coverage bandwidth. Do you have a smartphone? For example, yeah, thank you. If you have a smartphone, you probably, this is what, which carrier? AT&T, okay. So probably if you go to their new place, if you use AT&T, you're probably wondering how good bandwidth this phone provide. Do you have that kind of capture? Yes? No? Yeah. Okay, that is my current project. The idea is we develop software, okay? Software, I mean the app, Android app. Then install it, and then I go to the any location, specific location, and I click button. Then it shows what? Bandwidth, meaning, oh, upload speed and download speed. Like, oh, your upload speed is 1 mega per sec, or your download speed is 3 mega. Okay, it's acceptable, cool. But go to the my mom's house and measure it. Oh, it's only 10K or 30K. Okay, that kind of stuff. That is my current project. And actually, we sent 8 real testers like you, not like a student and somebody going outside in the throughout the whole state of California. So we measured 1,200 different locations speed. Okay, so that is first project and. We have several students who are working for this project as well. Second one was, it is actually, you know what? Second one is last year project with NPS. You know the NPS, right? NPS basically what? Military Naval Postgraduate School. So Naval, it's like military related. So they're correct? So, the idea is like this, soldier could have, for example, if you go to the field, there is no well-developed infrastructure for the communication. I mean, in here, we have several telecommunication switching system. This is already well-developed, so we don't have any problem, right? But if soldier go to the desert, there's no infrastructure, correct? In that situation, they wanna communicate each other. So that is what P2P communication on ad hoc network. Ad hoc networking meaning what? No infrastructure. How can I P2P, person peer-to-peer communication? That was last year project. And Kevin, here, this one, this is very, very long time ago. I developed compiler and debugger. Do you know compiler? How many of you guys know compiler? Okay, among CD students. Okay, you know the compiler. So I developed real compiler. Okay, so it was really challenging. And one of the difficult, very difficult software compiler. It's very hard. So any question? This is
Yeah.